Howdy folks and all the wonderful subscribers, it's me again, your chief marine mate, Edu. Before anything else, if you haven't subscribed yet, kindly click the subscribe button, notification bell, and click like if it pleases you. Today I will be introducing a topic, but it's not actually a lecture, but it's just a promotional video about a software that I have developed 3 years ago, I think, if I'm not mistaken. It is based on C# language programming, and I think it's a little bit of a combination of C# and C++. I do not need to mention all those things, but I have my personal thoughts of it. I program it myself, and of course I have published it, which is, it can run in Windows OSS and Linux, both desktop and your so-called laptop applications. I have not developed it in any mobile application or mobile-based application because it's too small, the screen is too small, and even in iPads and other tablet devices, that will be really small. But anyway, to give you an overview, this software actually is for developing courses and also at the same time managing courses. There's a single type of application, and there's also the so-called multiple type of application, meaning to say you can log in all at the same time simultaneously, and it can cater more than 100 rooms or 100 facilitators at the same time. Anyway, we'll just talk about these features. So as you can see the picture or image on my side, that is the so-called course vault management system, or we can also term it as course repository system. So meaning to say, it is capable of creating courses, capable of maintaining, storing courses, archival, and actually you can create a lot of or utilize and maximize its feature, from facilitation to storing your presentation for your cluster. It's actually mainly intended for the maritime institution, but actually it can be utilized to any maritime colleges or even universities that does not cater maritime courses. I mean to say, it's very general. You can actually modify the forms, and of course you can create a whole compendium out of it, or in most cases we call it as syllabus. So those who are professors in universities, teachers alike, and facilitators, they can actually use this, and it's basically a system that is caters everything. You can see the pictures. Now, I have divided this into two segments. The first half segment is actually spoken in, explained in English, although it's not my native language, so forgive me about that. I hope you'll be able to understand it anyway, like I'm talking to you right now. And at the same time, the last segment, which is from middle to end, is a combination of Taglish, Tagalog and English. So this is actually intended for those who would like to understand it further in their own native tongue, while the first one will be for the English speakers and who doesn't understand Tagalog. So anyway, I just hope that I'll be managed to get you an overview of this, and we'll be able to lay it out properly. So the next following video that I'm presenting is about the software itself. So,
welcome. This is an introduction to CVMS, or Course Vault Management System. This application software is a flexible means of storing, archival, documenting and safekeeping of maritime courses. It's a fully organized method that consolidates into one system where managing courses for delivery and development is faster and secured. This includes classroom materials assignment and course creation, such as compendiums and related items. Managed and efficient means of presenting classrooms, lectures and course development. You can easily create new courses with editable templates, modify or edit and publish them accordingly. Monitoring course development progress is a breeze. Designate role or assign instructors or course developers level of accessibility. Please check the full features and product offering as follows. This product is offered in three versions. Number 1, single or standalone version. Number 2, standard or suite version installed locally per PC and with database and server location which is accessed through LAN or intranet. And number 3, standard or suite versions with server-side installation only and accessed through your LAN or intranet and even internet using VPN. You may download this tabulated list of details for further information checked on the link shown in the above description. For more inquiries, email us with the address provided.
Good day mga sirs. Ito po yung introduction ko ng course repository and management system. As you can see, this kind of system is capable of storing, archival, filing, editing, modifying, uploading, downloading, and basically all na pwede nyong gawin sa course development, course facilitations, and management of courses. This is the area of course development, for example. As you can see, you can view, you can develop, you can publish. Depende po dun sa settings ng admin. You can control the publishing, kung pwede siya mapublish, anong ganyan pwedeng i-facilitate, anong araw. And as you can see here, you will be able to select also the courses that you want him or her to deliver, including yung pagpapublish kung pwede siyang magpublish o hindi, pwede siyang mag-view o hindi, at kung kaya niyang i-access o pwede niyang i-access yung courses. In this area is the course development. As you can see, instructor manual, course specs, course materials, even course cover, yung compendium, pwede kayong gumawa, andyan na. Ayan, halo-halo, course framework. You can edit it. In the course material, drag and drop, you can put in images, create new titles, drag in new images, remove these images, or add and remove ka lang. Even videos, any file format from ABI, ano kahit ano, pwede MPEG, MPG, WMV, MP4. And you can even put terminologies or definitions, unlimited po yan, related sa kurso. Even notes na may litrato and PowerPoints of any format. And HTML5, yung mas maganda po na pwedeng gamitin. There is a conversion na pwede pong pang-convert ng PowerPoint. So as you can see, natapos nyo na po yung paglalagay ng materials, you can now go to the course na assigned to you kung ano yung assign mo doon instructor. In this example, si Jando, day 1 lang ang pwede niya ma-access. So ngayon, iloload niya yung anchor handling. As you can see, day 1 pinili niya, pumasok na agad yung day 1. You can show the specification of the course, timetable, schedule, even the instructor's profile. And then, ma-access mo na yung mga materials. Images, videos, terminologies, notes, and so on and so forth. Per course po yan. At kung ano yung binigay na access accessibility or permit sa inyo. As you can see dito, clinic natin yung bridge resource, hindi niya ma-access dahil hindi yan naka-assign sa kanya. Cargo handling, hindi niya rin kayang accessin dahil hindi naka-access. So in that area of instructors, management and developers area, you can actually manipulate and control everything from developers to instructions and facilitations. Limbawa, dito si Captain Ray, siya ay course development lang at he can access or he can publish the facilitation. Now, meron siyang option dito to access the facilitation kasi kung nagde-develop siya ng material and he would like to see how it goes kung doon sa facilitation, ano ang ng view niya, then he will be able. If you take that out, he won't be able to mawawala po to. Hindi niya makikita itong mga to. And then of course, ang makikita lang doon sa station ay facilitation and course development. Depende po doon sa role niya. Ito hindi makikita doon sa mga classroom. Makikita lang itong mga repository management, instructors development management, etc. sa administration area. So tulad sa training manager, R&D o kaya yung kanyang training assistant and so on and so forth. So ito po yung kanang system. Now as you can see also, dito po, meron po tayong restriction. Meron nga super admin, admin, instructor, assessor, exam proctor, course developer, training manager. So nandun po yung degree ng permits mo kung paano mo tignan. Then this can be accessed eventually. Right. So ito po yung kabuuan ng kuan at yung pong gawa na ngayon actually malapit na pong matapos o pwede na po for kuan is the so called pang freelance or instructors. So as you can see there is a single edition pang individual and freelance and training center edition. As you can see, meron po siyang course repository management pero wala siyang instructors or developers management. Yung training center edition 2, meron siya. While yung server edition, sa ini-install lang po to sa server side and you will be able to see the rest of this Bibigyan ko po kayo ng kopya nito para mapag-aralan nyo mabuti at makita nyo. But the working demo, I can probably produce or publish at the end of this month. At meron po siyang 10 to 15 days trials after which mag-express siya. And from there, makikita nyo po. Ito po yun, single edition. Yung second edition or training center edition will be available on May or June. At ganun din po yung edition 2. While yung 2 server edition, depende po yan sa commitment ng client with the developer kung gusto nilang mapagawa. Sa madalit sabi, hindi pa ho ginagawa ito. Pwedeng gawin. Hindi lang po pwedeng ilatag at ipakita kaagad kasi marami pong trabaho ang banat dito. Anyway, that's the presentation. I hope you'll be able to get the whole idea and concept of this product offering that I am showing to you. And hopefully, you'll find somewhere there na kung merong applicability and usage na sa tingin nyo ay magiging positive ang output at productive kayo para gamitin ito, then please let me know. Thank you.